day's celebration of the Eucharist, we hope and pray that each and every one of us, wherever we may be, will encounter something to God's enfolding love. We acknowledge the Kunjin Jamara people, the traditional custodians of the land on which we gather, and we give respect to their local elders, past, present, and emerging. We offer this celebration in union with the churches around the world, but particularly this day, with grateful hearts for the work and ministry of Mothers Union around the world, and especially for our own members. At the name of Jesus, every knee must bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth. Christ became obedient for us, even to death, dying on the cross. Therefore, to the glory of God the Father, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Compassion and forgiveness belong to the Lord our God, though we have rebelled against him. Let us then renounce our willfulness and ask his mercy by confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness and cleanse me from my sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Make me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, have mercy on us. Let us pray. Father, in your plan of salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, accepted the cross and freed us from the power of the enemy. May we come to share the glory of his resurrection, where he lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
First reading is a reading taken from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 50, beginning at verse 4. The Lord has given me a disciple's tongue, so that I may know how to reply to the wearied. He provides me with speech. Each morning he wakes me to hear, to listen like a disciple. The Lord has opened my ear. For my part, I made no resistance, neither did I turn away. I offered my back to those who struck me, my cheeks to those who tore at my beard. I did not cover my face against insult and spittle. The Lord comes to my help, so that I am untouched by the insults. So too, I set my face like flint. I know I shall not be ashamed. My vindicator is here at hand. Does anyone start proceedings against me? Then let us go to court together. Who thinks he has a case against me? Let him approach me. The Lord is coming to my help. Who dare condemn me? This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is Psalm 68. And the response, Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Lord, in your great love, answer me.
It is for you that I suffer taunts, that shame covers my face, that I have become a stranger to my brothers, an alien to my own mother's sons. I burn with zeal for your house, and taunts against you fall on me.
Lord,
in your great love, answer me. Taunts have broken my heart. I have reached the end of my strength. I looked in vain. vain for compassion, for consolers, not one could I find. For food they gave me poison, in my thirst they gave me vinegar to drink. Lord, in your great love, answer me. I will praise God's name with a song. I will glorify him with thanksgiving. The poor, when they see it, will be glad, and God-seeking hearts will revive. For the Lord listens to the needy and does not spurn his servants in their chains. Lord, in your great love, answer me.
Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Hail to our King, obedient to the Father. He went to his crucifixion like a gentle lamb. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Then one of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said, "What will you give me if I deliver him to you?" And they paid 30 pieces of silver. And from that moment, he sought an opportunity to betray him. Now on the first day of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus, saying, "Where will you have us prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He said, "Go into the city to a certain one and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is at hand. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples.'" And the disciples did as Jesus had directed, and they prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he sat at table with the 12 disciples. And as they were eating, he said, "Truly, I say to you, one of you will betray me." And they were very sorrowful, and began to say to him, one after another, "Is it I, Lord?" He answered, "He who has dipped his hand in the dish with me will betray me. The Son of Man knows that it is written of him, but woe to the one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that man if he had never been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Is it I, Master?" He said to him, "You have said so." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
Sit for a moment's reflection. In this most unusual Holy Week, we are reminded again of Jesus' willingness to sit with his disciples and journey with them, to give them encouragement, but also to talk and speak words of truth. Judas betrays Jesus. "Is it I, Master?" he said. And Jesus replies, "You have said so." Sometimes in the frailty of our own humanity, we too betray Jesus. The journey of Holy Week, though, and the unfolding days ahead reminds us that Jesus redeems us and empowers us with the grace of the Holy Spirit through the waters of baptism to be people who can journey onward even in the midst of our own frailty. Well, the pray for all people and the church throughout the world. Creator God, we pray for the world. We especially remember those countries that are overwhelmed by the COVID-19 virus, and for countries where the resources to fight the virus are limited. We are grateful for the leaders of this nation and pray for them in all the difficulties and the choices that they make on our behalf. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of hope, we pray for your worldwide church, particularly for the work and ministry of Mothers Union throughout the world. We pray for places where Mothers Union seeks to relieve the poverty and the vulnerability of others. We pray for Gary, our bishop, and the faith communities, and this diocese, and the clergy who lead them. May we all be signs of your hope within the world. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of love, we pray for our community. In this time of isolation, may our community's spirit be strong. We pray for families at risk of family violence and for parents facing the challenge of managing children for extended periods. We pray for our healthcare workers and essential services. For our small businesses, and for those who have lost livelihoods and jobs recently. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of compassion, we pray for those who are in need, for the vulnerable, the troubled, those who are unwell in body, mind, and spirit, for the homeless, and for refugees. For those in our hospitals or aged care facilities, for those living alone, and those who feel fearful or anxious at this time. We remember those who grieve the death of loved ones. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God, our Father, we pray for our families, our neighbours, and our friends. Hard to be geographically distant from those we love at this time. Be with those we love to comfort and support them. May they know our love and your love. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of heaven and earth, we remember the faithful part of all those who have gone before us in faith and hope and who have died. Grant them rest and peace. May they know your loving presence and grace. May they know something of our affection and love for them. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and may light perpetual shine upon them. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us access to his grace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
you, which earth has given into human hands, that may become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my friends, my brothers and sisters in Christ, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the good of all his church and world. God, our Creator, may our gifts of bread and wine, which we offer your name, be signs of our love and desire to serve you, strengthen us on our journey through Lent. May our celebration enable us to challenge violence, injustice, and oppression, and work for peace and reconciliation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God and everlasting Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For in these 40 days you lead us into the desert of repentance, and through a pilgrimage of prayer and discipline, though so that we may grow in grace and learn to be your faithful people once again. Through prayer and fasting and acts of love, you bring us back to your generous heart. Through study of your holy word, you open our eyes to your presence in the world, and free our hands to welcome others into the radiant splendour of your love. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, ever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Father, you are holy indeed, and all creation rightly gives you praise. All life, all holiness comes from you through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, by the working of the Holy Spirit. From age to age you gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a perfect offering may be made to the glory of your name. And so, Father, we bring you these gifts of bread and wine. We ask you to make them holy by the power of your Spirit, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this Eucharist. On the night that he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And when he had given you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is the way when supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the cup to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Proclaim the mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Father, calling to mind the death your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, and ready to greet him when he comes again, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favour on your church's offering and see the victim whose death has reconciled us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by his body and blood, may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make us an everlasting gift to you and enable us to share in the inheritance of your saints. With Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. George, St. Peter and St. Paul, St. Andrew and St. Martin, St. Columba, St. Cuthbert, St. Chad, St. Benedict, with Mary Sutton, with the martyrs of Papua New Guinea, St. Francis and St. Clair, and with all your saints on whose constant friendship and intercession we rely for help. Lord, may this Eucharist, which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation and healing of all the world. Strengthen in faith and love your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Gary, our bishop and all bishops, with the clergy and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Father, in the silence, hear the prayers of the faithful family you have gathered here before you. In mercy and love, unite all your children wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom our departed sisters and brothers and all who have left this world in your friendship and our love. We hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, gracious Father, for ever and ever. Amen. 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 Trusting in the compassion of God, as our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy and love we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. We await the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in one bread. It is mingling the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, bring eternal life to all God's people. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take Precious God, you increase our faith and hope in this celebration of the Eucharist. Help us to reflect on your words and seek Christ our living bread. May this Eucharist strengthen us as we journey through this most holy week. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for God's blessing. May God the Father, who does not despise the broken spirit, give you a contrite heart.
Amen.
May Christ, who bore our sins in his body on the tree, heal you by his wounds.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit, who leads us into all truth, speak to you words of pardon and peace.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you, remain with you, and be with all those you love and hold dear, now, the ages of ages, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
God of our pilgrimage, you have fed us with the bread of heaven.
Refresh and sustain us as we go forward on our journey.
This is love, not that we love God,
but that he loved us and sent his Son.
He is the sacrifice for our sins,
that we might live through him.
If God loves us so much,
we ought to love one another.
If we love one another,
God lives in us.
Go in the peace of Christ, glorifying the Lord by your word.